a personal voyage through the khandhas, the aggregates. So this is I consider this a form of meditation, but it's analytical, so it's not arupa jhana, it's not jhana in the sense that it's not absorption. It is the analytical part of the mind is present, but that one observes the aggregates through analysis. And so, or philosophizing, if you like. And so, this is not vipassana, it's vipassanuk, thinking it, not doing it. And perception and memory. The reality we are locked inside, or the reality we perceive through perception, and we react to it and we experience it in whatever way we experience it, as enjoyable, displeasurable, pleasurable, unpleasant, exciting, scary, ambient, whatever. You sat on the beach on holiday on the desert island, or you're sat in a prison cell, or you're locked up and tied to a chair about to be tortured and questioned, or laid in a hammock somewhere, or sat in the office working. The feeling is different, and it's all coming through perception. Perception of what we see, how we perceive it. How do we perceive it? Because of memory and association. And this is one of the khandhas, this is one of the aggregates, the sanya, the fourth aggregate. If you list it how it's usually listed, it would be the fourth. Sanya is something like how you get your picture on your TV screen is transmitted from a satellite or a transmitter as a signal, and is then translated into a picture on your screen. Well, that's how pain enters your awareness, and that's how your visual experience of the world around you, what you see, arrives in your consciousness, and how the pain you feel or the pleasurable physical sensations you have, if somebody tickles your neck or massages you, feels good. Why does it feel good and not bad? Because you want to be massaged. Why? Because you remember it, and you remember the nice feeling you had from it, you remember the feeling, and you liked the feeling. So all of these reactions happen through these perceptions. Perceptions condition us. Perceptions, they condition our reactions because of our memory of other perceptions, and we associate them. And so if we smell something and it smells, or we go out on the farm and we smell the smell of the farm, we don't like it because it smells of shit. And we know what shit smells like, so when we smell the farm smell, it reminds us of shit. And so we have a kind of abhorrent reaction if we're not used to it. Or we see a load of worms in a pile and we have a reaction. Or we see a bowl of rice and we have another reaction. And we see a pile of gravel and we have another reaction. But a pile of rice and a pile of gravel, they're both piles of little particles of something, something elemental. But when we see the cooked rice, our mouths water. When we see the pile of gravel, nothing happens. You might just think it looks pretty disgusting, maybe, or just have a neutral feeling. It's been conditioned. And so these transmissions of information through the senses, be they visual, be they smells, be they tastes, be they physical sensations, you're being massaged or whatever, or you bump into something and hurt yourself. Or you hear sounds, you think it's music or it's just a noise. All of this, it becomes music through memory and perception and memory association. That's one of the khandhas, and the transmission of this information into your consciousness. And your consciousness is one of the other aggregates, the fifth aggregate, vijnana, consciousness. And sanya is the fourth aggregate, the transmitter of information, and memory of information, because any information transmitted to you becomes memory, it remains. Once it's been transmitted, it can't be lost. You can file it away in your brain so you can't find it, so you think you can't remember it, but it's actually there. You just can't remember it, you can't access it, but it's there. Everything you've seen and heard since the moment you were born is there. What you saw and what you heard changed as you became conditioned. As a little baby, you were looking at a blurry cloud of something. It took a long time for it to become a TV on a table with a painting on the wall behind it. At first, the baby's not conditioned, he just sees a blur. He can't separate the individual objects. He hasn't developed that concept yet of conditioning through sanya, perception and memory, entering his vijnana, transmitting information and conditioning it, which is also sanya is the third aggregate, the fourth aggregate is sankhara, which means conditioned things, mental formations, and all things that are conditioned, tables and chairs and clouds and your thoughts. So you smell something, your memory, you perceive it in your consciousness, that's two aggregates connecting, and then your memory association says, oh, that smells like strawberry ice cream, and you remember eating strawberry ice cream and enjoying it, and you get an excited feeling, and that feeling is an emotion, that is the second aggregate, vedana, feelings, reactions, and the reaction would be, that smells like strawberry ice cream, and you get a feeling, yeah. And that's all four aggregates of five. The fifth is rupa, is forms which you might perceive, and your own physical form, your body. And so within the form, the first aggregate, you have feelings arising. This vetana form is rupa, the first aggregate, your body, and all other bodies, all everything in material universe that is physical is conditioned and limited. That is rupa, the first aggregate. And within this rupa, you can find the second aggregate, which is vetana, which is feelings, emotions, reactions, which happen because of its connection with the third aggregate, the third khanda, which is sanya, which is the transmission of information, perception and memory. And that memory association of perceived things in the fifth aggregate, vijnana, the consciousness, then conditions things into the fourth aggregate, sankhara, conditioned things, thought formations, into that smells like strawberry ice cream, yeah? Or into, yeah, that smells like strawberry ice cream. And when that happens, the sanya transmits this thought back to the vijnana, the fifth aggregate, the consciousness. And when the consciousness becomes aware of that this smells like, not just that there is a smell, that you have thought and conditioned in the fourth aggregate, sankhara, that this smell is like strawberry ice cream, it's then sent back with the third aggregate, sanya, transmission, perception, to the fifth aggregate, vijnana, the consciousness, that it's not just a smell, it's a smell that's like strawberry ice cream, which then triggers the second aggregate, vedana, emotions, reactions, into, I like strawberry ice cream, that's a nice smell. So it's not a bad smell. It's not just a smell, who cares? It's a nice smell. And all that has happened within that first khanda, first aggregate, the body, all is in a chain going around. Yeah. But when the vijnana, the fifth aggregate, the fifth khanda, became aware that the smell it had recently been just made aware of was like strawberry ice cream, according to the conditioned mind. If you had eaten ice cream as a child, strawberry ice cream, and made yourself sick and had a really bad experience, as soon as the mind would have remembered the bad experience of being sick on strawberry ice cream, instead of then triggering the vetana, the second aggregate emotions, reactions, to be, that's strawberry ice cream, I like strawberry ice cream, that's a good smell, that's a nice smell. Instead, the reaction would be, oh, that smells like that strawberry ice cream that I puked up that time. Ooh, that's a horrible smell. Yeah. And if you were enlightened to both of those truths, that both of those are just conditioned reactions, then you would probably feel neither of those if you were already past that point. But you might feel, it's just a smell. It's just a smell. And the reason my body's feeling disgusted is because I once puked it up, but actually it's not disgusting, it's just like being conditioned by my memory of a previous event. And you would say, well, that's just a chemical reaction in my body, but it's not me. I am apart from that, and I cannot let it influence me and just ignore it and let it just run around inside my tummy there, let my chest just twitch a bit there because it doesn't like it, but I don't care because that's not me. If that's how you felt, then I would say something has happened in your practice and that you have advanced. Anyway, that was a slight journey through the khandhas, as I journey through them when I am contemplating in my daily activities. That's running in, program is running in the background all the time. And so I thought I'd share it with you. This is Ajahn Spencer for the Buddha Magic Project, signing off.